Allulose. Will this guilt-free sweetener replace sugar? Hey there, Bestie fans. If you've been following our content for a while, you probably know by now the negative health effects that can happen as a result of too much sugar in your diet. If you're new here, check out our previous video, 8 warning signs that you're eating too much sugar, in order to get up to speed. So, what's a person with a sweet tooth to do? If excess sugar is bad for us, is there any way to maintain a healthy, sugar-free diet while still enjoying a sweetened snack every now and then? As it turns out, there might be some good news on the way for people who don't want to cut out sweets from their diet entirely. At this time of writing, the FDA has just given a pass to a sugar-free sweetener known as Allulose. But is it safe? Before we continue, we think it would be sweet if you subscribed to Bestie and rang the notification bell to stay up to date on all of our daily videos and content. Now, let's talk about allulose, also known as D-psicose. Allulose is a brand new, low-calorie sweetener that somehow manages to look, taste, and even feel just like real sugar. Despite the similarities, allulose only contains about 0.4 calories per gram. In other words, 1/10 of the calories you can expect from ordinary table sugar. What's more, allulose does not share ordinary sugar's detriments when it comes to dental health. Meaning, you can hypothetically eat food sweetened by allulose without the fear of dental decay or cavities. For anyone with a major sweet tooth, this is sure to be some great news. But also, it makes you wonder, is this new sugar alternative too good to be true? What even is allulose anyways? Well, according to Jagan Momoser in his article for Healthline, allulose happens to share many of its similarities with sugar because, well, technically, it's sugar, or at least a specific type of it. Feeling confused yet? Well, allow us to explain. Unlike other attempts to replace sugar using artificial sweeteners, allulose is a R sugar, which occurs naturally in a small handful of whole foods such as wheat, figs, raisins, and jackfruit. From a chemical standpoint, allulose is nearly identical to fructose, one of the two major components that make up table sugar. Compared to ordinary sugar, allulose retains about 70% of the sweetness and tastes exactly similar to regular table sugar. So, what does this discovery mean for long term? Well, for starters, the Food and Drug Administration, otherwise known as the FDA, has just issued a draft guidance for all food products which contain allulose. What this means is that products don't have to list allulose as part of the total added sugars declaration on its nutritional information packaging. And as Momoser wants to remind us, that's a big deal. For a little bit of reference, this is the first time ever, that the FDA has allowed a product's sugar content to be excluded from its packaging. Allulose will still appear under the product's ingredients list, of course, as well as the declaration for the product's total carbohydrates and calories. Even so, to say this is unprecedented is still a huge understatement. According to the FDA themselves, the decision to give this one-of-a-kind leeway to products containing allulose is seen as a reflection of our flexible and science-based approach to food labeling. The fact that allulose is much less harmful for the body than sugar means that people with diabetes may be able to enjoy foods containing this sweetener without the fear of adverse health effects. The potential integration of allulose into more foods and products will also come as good news to anyone currently interested in a low-sugar or low-carb diet, such as the ketogenic diet and paleo diet. In turn, Momoser predicts that the FDA's decision is likely to spur further interest in the prospects of allulose for consumers. However, let's not get ahead of ourselves here. All of this news surrounding allulose is still mostly new developments, and if we really want to know how safe this allulose really is as a sugar substitute, more research needs to be done in order to monitor the sweetener's effects in the long term. As pointed out by the outpatient clinical dietitian Amy Jamison-Pitonic of the University Hospitals Medical Center, some of the studies into allulose were conducted on animals as opposed to humans, which means that not all of their findings may necessarily translate to the human body. A few small human trials have started to be conducted to further understand the effects allulose might have on our body, if any. According to some sources, allulose might potentially be able to help control and moderate the human body's blood sugar levels. However, the majority of allulose-related testing so far has been conducted on rats, which means that more human-focused studies will be required in order to gain a more complete understanding. At the very least, the discovery of allulose as a potential alternative to sugar brings the most promise that people who can't or don't want to eat processed sugars have an alternative that is potentially healthier on the horizon. However, at the end of the day, allulose is still a type of sugar, so remember to enjoy it responsibly. Just because it's healthier doesn't mean you should eat more of it. So, what does the future hold for foods like allulose? Well, at this time of writing, it may be too early to say. However, anyone looking to reduce their intake of sugar and processed foods may want to keep an eye on how news surrounding allulose continues to develop. And we here at Bestie will be sure to do our part to keep you up to speed on any new breakthroughs regarding the sweetener as well. So, what do you think of this news? We'd love to hear your responses to these new developments. Let us know in the comment section below and keep the conversation going. Since these are also new developments, be sure to spread the word by sharing this video around as well. And as always, thanks for watching. Enjoyed this video? Hit the like button and share with your friends. Also, subscribe to our channel for more videos like this. Thanks for watching.